Can cell phones actually increase our risk of tooth decay? Aloha, I'm Will with Aura Wellness, and today we're going to explore a simple facial massage technique to help you lower your risk of tooth decay that may actually help you feel better and look younger. This knowledge comes out of the work of Dr. Ralph Steinman. Dr. Steinman was a dental researcher in the late 1970s. Fundamentally, what Dr. Steinman discovered is that our teeth are alive and have a flow of fluid through them called dentinal fluid flow. So what does this all have to do with cell phones? Well, Dr. Steinman found that dentinal fluid flow is controlled by the parotid gland, which is part of our salivary system located on both sides of our lower jaw region here. Then he discovered that the parotid gland is controlled by a part of our brain called the hypothalamus, which is a deep part of the brain that sits roughly right between our ears. The problem is that, as we all know, a cell phone emits electromagnetic radiation, which can function as a radio scrambler for cellular communication. The closer living tissues are to the source of this radiation, the worse the risk of cellular damage. So the parotid gland sits in the lower jaw region here. It literally sits right where we hold the cell phone to our heads. So how can we mitigate the potential damage without throwing away our cell phones? We went back into our background in the Chinese longevity arts to find ancient solutions for modern problems like this. Here's the premise how to stop the risk of cell phones scrambling the dentinal fluid transport system and causing tooth decay. First, let's establish that everything living benefits from loving touch. I mean, think about it. Who doesn't appreciate a loving touch, a pat on the back, a shoulder rub, or a massage? Cats and dogs are gluttons for it, right? Research has shown that plants grow stronger and healthier when exposed to loving touch. Massage has been proven to reduce inflammation, to increase healing rate, to increase circulation. Bottom line, living organisms benefit from healing and tension through touch. We would go so far as to say that all living tissues benefit from loving touch. So we're going to leverage this health-giving nature of loving touch to soothe and support the scrambled hypothalamus parotid gland pathway. You can use this sequence daily or simply learn the techniques and apply them when you feel you could use some support, perhaps after a long conversation on your cell phone. This first exercise is called beating the drum. This exercise is to help center your awareness towards your hypothalamus, and this will function as a gentle wake-up knock to your hypothalamus. Those of you familiar with the benefits of tapping will recognize the benefit of this exercise right away. We're going to place our hands over our ears. Then gently tap left, right, left, right, left, right with the first two fingers on the base of our skull brainstem region. Here's what it looks like from the back view. Just a quick rhythmic left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right. If you're on the right spot, you'll hear a dong, 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 dong drumming in your head. Do this approximately 25 times each side. Now that we have our hypothalamus paying attention, we're going to directly massage the region of the parotid glands. For this technique, we're going to gently draw up and down across the jawline and in front of our ears with our full palms. We're going to use this back and forth motion, massaging along the lower jawline. Also note, I like to wrap my thumbs around and under the edge of the lower jaw to get into the soft tissue here as well. So to better support a healthy youthful glow, we want the downward pressure to be less than the upward pressure. No need to help gravity pull our faces down, right? You want to use enough pressure here to stimulate and activate the tissues of the face, but not so much pressure that you contort or otherwise stress the tissue. Remember, it's like you're giving a loving touch on the cheek to a young family member. Repeat this technique 10 to 12 times, ending on the upstroke. Try it with me now. So we're going to go down and back up. Finishing on the upstroke. So there's a sequence to stimulate our hypothalamus, support our parotid glands, and help mitigate any cellular scrambling our cellular phones may cause to our natural ability to resist tooth decay. If you like this information, please let us know by posting a comment on our blog, as we have a lot more information how ancient wisdom and strategies like this can help us thrive in this modern age to share with you, but we need to hear if you like this type of information from us. And if you'd like to learn more about how to support your body's natural ability to be cavity-free by supporting your dentinal fluid transport system, be sure to check out our free video series called The 5 Steps to a Healthy Mouth, as well as read the articles on our blog on tooth decay. Aloha until the next time. May your bright, healthy smile continue to bless your life and the lives of those around you. And remember, It doesn't cost a thing to smile.